So far, the flow has been a spectacle and not a disaster, except for the Mauna Loa Observatory. Lava has cut off access and power for the foreseeable future at the worldwide headquarters for climate change data. Its staff are in limbo as to how its science of global importance can resume.
Since the 1950s, an observatory like no other has been the place where scientists and their instruments gather data only Mauna Loa can help access at its towering 11,000-foot vantage point.
It's well above the trade wind inversion, and this allows us to measure the atmosphere, we call it the free atmosphere, that upper part of the troposphere, and it gives a wonderful snapshot as to how it is that the atmosphere is changing globally.
That snapshot includes a series of CO2 measurements since 1958 on what's known as the Keeling Curve, named for Charles David Keeling. It's the foundation of climate change research. It's a record unbroken for decades. That is, until Monday morning when fissures opened up just upslope of the observatory.
Fissure 1 would have been very close to the observatory itself. There was nobody on site. So everyone was at home preparing for the day. We no longer usually have to overnight at the facility. So that was a really good thing. Nobody had to be evacuated.
Just after nightfall Monday evening, lava cut across the road, and it happened again. There's no power and no practical way to get back to work, except for a helicopter landing pad for emergencies. Decades of data dots gave way to blank spots.
Everything's on backup power that can last, seconds to hours to handle brownouts and blackouts that might happen throughout the year. But once we lost power and the power poles got taken out, all of our instruments basically went dark within a couple of hours.
How critical is continuity of data for the kind of work you're doing there?
Continuity is very important. So if we can get it on here and, the next month or whenever we do, we should be able to pretty easily connect the dots. We will also, make that well known that there's a larger amount of error in this year's data collection due to this volcanic activity.
Mauna Loa Observatory is the premier atmospheric baseline monitoring station in the world. There are three other NOAA baseline observatories elsewhere and 100 locations that collect weekly samples for similar data.
Since we do have such a long record, we will have some way to be able to interpolate through that gap, but let's hope that the gap isn't too long.
They're looking at relocation options, but
Mauna Loa is situated in an ideal location, and our record is at Mauna Loa, so our main priority is to return to Mauna Loa as soon as possible.
I asked how he and the 8 staff assigned to Mauna Loa Observatory are doing emotionally as the first and only place incapacitated so far by this flow.
We're dealing with it just like, any other resident of the island, is coping with the fact that there's this massive fireball erupting in our backyard. For the sake of Hilo and Kona and all the residences and the residents of the island, it's flowing in the perfect location, really. It's away from anyone's home. So if Mauna Loa Access Road has to be the sacrificial lamb in this situation, then, we're happy to pay that price.
Indeed. A steep price for now.